Hi, I'm Dr. Lisa Thompson of drlisamthompson.com, and I have a question for you. Who do you surround yourself with and hang out with every day? I want you to pay very close attention in answering that question because that's going to determine how well you're going to succeed in your business. And what we're going to explore today is the law of the inner circle. This is a law that is talked about in John Maxwell's book, The 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership. Now, you've heard it said by Jim Rohn and some other leaders that your success is going to be determined by the five people you hang around the most. And that is absolutely true. Because a lot of times, many people, they don't achieve the level of success because they surround themselves with people who are too comfortable. A lot of times it's, you know, friends, you know, from high school, from college, maybe coworkers, and you get together and it's a comfortable routine. Nobody wants to, you know, kind of break out and do more. And whenever somebody tries something new, they tend to pull them back. They tend to laugh at them. They're like, why do you want to do that? And it's out of a fear of loss. Those people who you hang around with. If you're wanting to move more and go more and try to be more, and they're comfortable where they're at, they're going to do everything they can to hold you back in order for them to remain and feel good. And that's not what's going to help you. If you want to grow, you want to make an impact in the world, you have to surround yourself with people who are going to help you raise your level, your game level. Take you to a point where you can make that impact, where you can make your dreams come true, okay? Because your friends, the people who you surround yourself with, they're not going to pay the bills. Their opinions don't pay your bills. They don't pay for your dreams, okay? So if your dreams matter, you have a mission that matters, then you need to sit and really think hard about who you need to surround yourself with. So if you're struggling to figure out, well, who do I need to surround myself with? John Maxwell gives you five criteria that you need to look at. And so when you're looking at your friends, see if they meet these criteria. Okay, so we're going to break these down here. Point number one, do they have a high influence with others? Okay, do they have a high influence with others? So with the influences, are they someone who can help lead others? Do other people respect their opinions? Do other people follow them? Okay, so if you've got people who are attracted because of their personality, because they're out there, they're positive, they're not being negative, you know, that's what you have to look at, their degree of influence. Number two, do they bring a complimentary gift to the table? And that means, do they sit there and they ask questions about others? Do they look at empowering and building others up? Are they respectful of listening and are open to different opinions, ideas, and beliefs? A lot of times you may have friends who say it's their way or it's the highway. When you want to go out and do something, maybe it's trying something different, like a new restaurant or a new routine with getting together, or you want to add someone new to the inner circle, you might have people who sit there and they're like, no, 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 no. Okay, so you have to be careful of that. Number three, do they hold a strategic position? There are, you know, think about that. In your circle of influence, your group of people, you know, sometimes there's a person there who's like the natural leader, okay? And they're the ones whose ideas everybody seeks out, the opinions and everything, okay? And so you have to make sure that everybody's kind of on the same page. Number four, do they add value? Okay, in meaning of adding value, are they out there building people up? Are they sharing ideas? Are they sharing ways to make people better? Are they looking to the future? Are they solution oriented? Because how many times, and I'll tell you this, when I've gone out for happy hours with colleagues or out with friends, a lot of times the talk can go to bashing and complaining about the boss or complaining about other things that are going on. And it can provide an energy, and people get all caught up in it and revved up in it. But then afterwards, don't you feel real kind of tired and ugh? Okay? You feel grimy. You feel like, man, and you don't just want to do anything after being involved with something like that because it's so mentally draining. You want to be looking for people who are energy adders, not energy drainers. Okay, there's just two types of people out there in the world, those who add to your energy and those who detract. And so you need to make sure that you're spending your time with people who are going to add to your energy, because that's what's going to help you keep moving forward. And number five, do they positively impact other inner circle members? Okay, do they impact other people positively? Do they give encouragement? Do they give support? Do they validate and respect other opinions of the group? Okay, you know, if you got, you know, there's that phrase, one bad apple can spoil the whole bunch. And so sit there when you're looking at your inner circle and decide, where do you want to be? All right, and if you've got people who are not that, you know, they're very negative, they don't meet these criteria, then you've got to seek out new friends. Okay, and yeah, it's going to be painful, but is your dream worth it? Because think about this. If you're able to step up and grow, you're going to be able to impact more people. You're going to have people seeking you out. You're going to be seen as a leader. People are going to want to, you know, be attracted to you because of what you do and who you surround yourself with. Because people love being around a winning team. People who know where they're going. People who have a real positive attitude and realistic expectations of what's going on, and that people believe in them and in their journey. All right, and that's how you develop the posture. Posture is defined as belief in what you have without any external approval by anybody else. And the way you develop that belief is you've got to surround yourself with people who believe in your vision, who support you in your vision, who are going to give you that encouragement to keep going when you want to give up. So there you are, my friends. I hope you found this video valuable today. If you did, leave a comment and share. And if you do not have the copy of John Maxwell's book, The 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership, go pick it up on Amazon. It's available in paperback, Kindle, or Audible form. I have the link in the video description, as well as in the first pinned comment section below this video. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.